Hey, Pamela Hack here from Strada Toscana, and this is Strada TV, where you come for a glimpse of la bellezza, the beauty of Italian culture. And you know what? Today we're heading to Venezia. We're going to Venice to take a peek at the gondola. You know, the gondola, if you see other boats throughout Italy that look like they might be a gondola, they're not. Might be really similar, but the gondola is directly connected to Venice. Its history is there. And you know, it's said that there was a period in time centuries ago where there were 8 to 10,000 gondola all around the canals of Venice. That's hard to imagine because you go there today and they say there are just over 400, and it seems like they're everywhere. I can't imagine what that must have been like with thousands of gondola all along those canals. But today's gondola really comes from a style that came about in the 1800s. And you know what else they had during that time in the 1800s? They had cabins in the middle of the gondola, so you could close it up for privacy or if the weather got bad. So they were closed with these louvered shutters that came down. And if you're thinking along those lines, you're right. They were the first Venetian blinds. Isn't that so cool? And today's gondola is nothing less than a work of art. 280 different handcrafted pieces of wood in one gondola from 8 different types of trees, everything from mahogany to oak to cherry. How amazing! And that gondola of today is filled too with symbolism, of like the prow head on the thing, this big piece of iron with 6 prongs sticking out of it, each representing a district of Venice. And it's like a backwards S shape representing the canals of Venice. And the weight of that counterbalances the gondolier who's at the back. And at the back of that gondola, the gondolier places his oar in something called a forcola. That forcola, I'm telling you, is a piece of art. In fact, my friend Piero Dri, who has his shop in Venice, he makes, hand makes that forcola for the gondola, made from one solid piece of wood. It's the craziest looking thing, but it allows that gondolier to turn that oar in all different ways to maneuver that gondola. And to watch Piero at work is so fascinating. It's mesmerizing. And when you see the work, the craftsmanship, the skill that goes into pieces like that of this beautiful gondola, when you see it, you appreciate it even more, right? Better yet, when you have a ride in that gondola. I mean, that beautiful boat, what a slice of la bellezza of Italian culture. I'm Pamela Hack, and if you liked this, comment, share it, and don't forget, head over to stratatoscana.com and sign up to get updates and insider info. In the meantime, here's hoping that your travels are filled with la bellezza. I'll see you next time on Strada TV.
No.